When it comes to buying the right products, there's a lot to look out for. That's why today, we've picked and reviewed the 5 best models for you. And we've ranked them by many different factors, such as price, quality, durability, performance, and more. You can see their prices and find out more information by using the links in the description down below. Let's not waste any more time and get started with the video. We are going to start this list with the best budget option that you can get your hands on.
Number 5, TCL 6 Series 55R635. The 6 Series is brighter than before, more colourful, and doesn't have a single hint of haloing or light bleed. It's designed in a new way to hide your cables and the first TV to come with THX certified game mode for 1440p or 120Hz gaming. The TCL 6 Series is relatively slim, measuring 2.8 inches at the thickest point, but narrowing down to just 1 inch thick around the outside bezel. The design is actually a little bit boxy, but in line with past TCL designs. It emphasizes the display very well, with a frame-like bezel and chassis that's covered in what looks to be brushed metal. The brightness, black levels, and overall backlight control can be attributed to TCL's pioneering work in mini-LED technology, which is employed in the 6 Series this year, but was reserved for the 8K 8 Series last year. For those unfamiliar, mini-LED backlighting is a much more precise version of the standard LED backlight tech we've seen for years. In short, while a standard LED backlit TV might have a full array of just hundreds of LEDs, mini-LED uses tens of thousands of much smaller LED lights. The 55-inch TCL 6 Series has a big, bright 4K panel with QLED technology, enhancing the brightness and colors, and a 120Hz refresh rate providing smooth action for any content you want to watch. There was some minor banding in scenes where color transitions were especially subtle, like bright blue sky, but changes in tone left slightly posterized circles of color as sunlight shifted between shades of blue and yellow. The TCL 6 Series' weakest front is usually the audio quality offered by the pair of 8-watt speakers inside. They aren't as loud as we would like, and the lack of a subwoofer was noticeable when listening to test tracks, like the Deftones' Ohms. The pounding drums and crushing guitar sounded good, but the bass line lacked some of the oomph that normally round out the band's sound. The TCL 6 Series is an excellent television, especially given its price. A little work needs to be put on to get the best picture quality, but with our guidance and a little time, excellence is achievable.
If you binge watch your favorite movies or TV shows often, this next model would be a good fit for you.
Number 4. Samsung Q90T. The Samsung Q90T QLED TV is part of Samsung 2020 TV catalog and sits at the top of the manufacturer's QLED 4K lineup. There's higher-end 8K QLED TVs like the Q800T and the Q950T, but the Samsung Q90T is as premium as you can get with a 4K resolution. It's one of the best Samsung TVs for movies. The Samsung Q90T is actually a fair bit cheaper than last year's Samsung Q90R flagship because Samsung has made a few cuts in terms of the design of the TV. There's no One Connect box and there are fewer local dimming zones than last year. As is only fitting for a TV that costs a not inconsiderable sum of money, the Samsung Q90T is extensively packed with features. It has a 3840 by 2160 resolution for starters. Those millions of pixels are backlit using a full array local dimming arrangement which is divided into a little over 100 zones that can be controlled on an individual basis. That's not a huge number, truth be told, but it should be enough to give the QE55 Q90T a chance of offering good bright or dark contrast control and detail levels. Picture performance is augmented in a number of ways. There's HDR compatibility with HLG for broadcast TV, HDR10 and HDR10 Plus dynamic metadata. This being Samsung, there's no sign of Dolby Vision. Anti-reflective screen and ultra-wide angle technologies seek to minimize the effects of ambient lighting conditions and your viewing position. The smart TV interface and the fairly extensive setup menus can be navigated using one of the two bundled remote control handsets. One is a fairly nasty-looking and feeling handset with too many buttons, most of them too small, and the other is a more judicious and expensive-feeling alternative. There's a degree of voice control available too from Bixby and Amazon Alexa. Google Assistant should be making an appearance sooner rather than later. Putting our gripes with Bixby aside, Tizen delivers a phenomenally fast and responsive experience 99% of the time. It has almost every major streaming service and it goes from standby to streaming Netflix in under 20 seconds.
Next up, we have a model which gives you the best value for your money.
Number 3. Sony X900H. Moving on, we have an amazing 4K TV from Sony. It's the Sony X900H. It's also an Android TV with a new, more powerful SoC that has not been used in any previous Sony TV. The bezels enclosing that huge expanse of screen are slender and discreet, and the feet on which it stands are similarly skinny, flattened V-shape. It seems unlikely that a TV this big will be anything other than wall-mounted, even taking its significant 33kg weight into account. But should an owner be in possession of a surface wide enough to stand it on, there's more than enough space below the bottom of the screen for a substantial soundbar. Sony has put a lot of effort into improving the ability of its 4K TVs to upscale sub-4K content. By combining the prodigious power of its X1 4K HDR picture processing chip with an ever-expanding database of 4K relevant images, it intends to offer greater detail, texture, and, well, 4K-ness to 1080p material. And to a very great extent, that proves to be the case. With a solid basis of black, the X900H doesn't have to get extremely bright to appear vivid. Using Portrait Display's Kalman software and a Spectracl C6 colorimeter, I measured the X900H's peak brightness in a 10% window at 750 nits for a sustained period of time. All but the 55-inch model in the XH90 range feature Sony's grand-sounding acoustic multi-audio system. In practice, this equates to 20 watts powering two full-range drivers and a couple of tweeters positioned near the top of the back of the screen chassis, one on either side. Is Sony X900H the PlayStation 5 TV? Well, it's hard to say for sure until PlayStation 5 arrives, and even more crucially, until Sony releases the firmware required to enable HDMI 2.1 and related features. No timeline has been announced. However, we would argue that its mediocre HDR picture quality is a big limitation. More and more console games are released in HDR.
Before we talk about the best model overall, let's look at the runner-up for this list.
Number 2, LG C9. The runner-up on our list is the excellent LG C9, which is also one of the best high-end TVs out there. As you already know, LG has established itself as one of the best TV manufacturers out there, and this one solidifies its spot. This amazing TV delivers great image quality, superb black levels, amazing contrast, proper HDR support, and one of the best smart TV platforms out there. AI enhancement at its best. There are different versions of this TV available for you, which consist of the 55 and 65-inch versions, which deliver immense value for the price. Then again, there is the 77-inch model, which costs more than double the price of the 65-inch version. The design of this TV is exceptional overall. It is exceptionally thin, and it's one of the most aesthetically pleasing TVs ever made. The frame is made from aluminium with a gunmetal finish and a super slim bezel around the screen that makes it very attractive. Before moving on, I want to touch a bit more on the stand of the device, which supports the weight of this slim TV solidly. It's a single-piece, wide, flat-centered stand that rests proudly. On the stand, you'll also spot a channel for cable management to deliver a clean design. It has Visa mounting holes on the back, and I think it looks perfect mounted on the wall. For connectivity, it has plenty to offer, such as three USB ports, an RF port, an antenna tuner, composite and optical output port. In addition to all this, it has four HDMI 2.1 ports, which support 4K at 120 frames per second. In terms of image quality, the LG C9 is beautiful, especially when it comes to its vivid colors with superior accuracy. On top of that, the brightness is top of the class thanks to its OLED nature. Motion handling is very smooth, and it's one of the best TVs ever made. Upscaling works very well with the Alpha 9 second generation processor, and it works well with anything you can throw at it.
This next model is the best option for gaming, and I think that this would be a great fit for any type of gamer.
Number 1, LG CX. LG has chosen not to alter the appearance of its C-series between the 2019 and 2020 generations. While OLED panels themselves are extremely thin, the TV is more than just a panel. The speakers, connections, and processing bits and pieces still need to go somewhere, and on an OLED, they tend to go in a plastic enclosure attached to the back of the panel. That means that even though the CX is just 6mm at its edges, much of its chassis is 4.7cm deep. That's still thin by modern TV standards, but not by a huge margin. The flagship processor is the third generation version of the Alpha 9. The main upgrades are to artificial intelligence, with features such as AI Picture Pro, which LG says will enhance the resolution and sharpness of contents by an algorithm learned via an LG deep learning technique, and AI Sound Pro, which provides the optimal sound or virtual 5.1 surround, depending on the watching genre. Throughout testing, we find both features to be worth using. LG's 2020 OLED support the new Dolby Vision IQ format, though, which tailors the Dolby Vision performance to the ambient light in the room. The picture produced is an absolute joy. Beautifully crisp, natural and detailed with perfect inky blacks, the likes of which haven't previously been available from a TV this size in the 4K era. The same can be said of the viewing angles, which are practically perfect. In our testing, this reduces treble brightness and produces an overall smoother, more dynamic and more direct sound. There are plenty of people who want the best TV possible but don't necessarily want to go big, and those people have been rather left out through the 4K TV era. Finally, though, we have an OLED TV smaller than 50 inches, and what a TV it is. Buying guide. Size. Whether you're looking for a basic or high-performance TV, the biggest factor in your decision will probably be screen size. Consider how many people in your family typically watch at once and where you're going to put your new set. Then pick the largest screen size that'll fit comfortably into that space and your budget. The sweet spot today, considering price, performance, and the typical living room, is between 55 and 65 inches. Secondly, HDR. HDR is short for high dynamic range, and as far as we're concerned, when it's done right, it's a much more impressive change to overall picture quality than resolution alone. HDR makes images more vibrant and lifelike through higher brightness, contrast, and wider color gamut. That's the total number of colors a TV can display. At its best, HDR is truly stunning. You won't want to return to SDR, standard dynamic range, once you see it in action. And thirdly, refresh rate. A TV's refresh rate refers to how many individual frames per second it can display, denoted in Hertz, HZ. There are two different ways manufacturers refer to refresh rates, native and effective. How smoothly a TV displays motion is dependent on its native refresh rate. Generally, you want a 120Hz native refresh rate if you can get it, though we have seen some excellent 60Hz TVs out there. One thing to keep in mind is that only some kinds of content benefit from higher refresh rates, with sports being the poster child for 120Hz TVs. The fast action of games like hockey or motorsports is all the more thrilling when you can see the details instead of a blur. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you found it helpful, please remember to leave a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this in the future. If you have any questions related to these products, you can leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.